Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how you can validate your code. It's really important when you're creating websites to strive to make sure that your HTML and your CSS is valid and it's error-free. So there are a couple ways that you can do this. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to create a new page in Dreamweaver, and I'm using Dreamweaver CC, which stands for the Creative Cloud version, and I'm just going to go down here and click on HTML. We'll do three column, and for this case I'm just gonna leave this CSS to the head, and I'm gonna make sure this is an HTML5 document. So this just gives me something to show you. So with Dreamweaver, I'm gonna first save this. So with Dreamweaver, you have the ability to actually validate it right in Dreamweaver, and so you can go to File, go down to Validate, and validate with the W3C, and it's gonna tell you it's sending its information, and then down here it'll show you where you have an issue. So it's saying the attribute, and the great thing about this is it always tells you. So line 141, so this is where you can jump to your code and you can find out where the issue is. So in this case it's missing the file, so I'm just gonna add an image in there that doesn't really exist, but for the example, it doesn't matter. I'm going to save it. I'm going to validate again. And there it says no errors were found. So that's the basic idea behind validating your code. Now, I'm going to upload this to the EdTech2 server, and I'm going to show you how to use the online versions to validate your HTML as well as your CSS. Okay, so here's my file. I uploaded it to my EdTech2 account. There's some errors with the image, but this will give you the basic idea. So now, if I go to Google, and I just Google validate HTML5, you'll see the validator comes up. So this is where I can take this URL. I'm going to copy it, paste it in here, and it says that I successfully checked. It's error-free, gives me a warning about HTML5 being new, essentially. And then down here it says that if I would like to create a link to this page, that I can copy this link here. So I'm going to copy the link address, and this allows me to be able basically add an icon or a badge that says my code is valid, then every time I click on it, it'll recheck my page. So let's go back to Dreamweaver. We're gonna put it here down at the footer. We'll just put it right here. So first thing I'm gonna do actually is I'm going to Google validation badges. So there's a lot of different ones that you can use out there. However, what I like are these newer ones, because validation badges or icons showing that your code is out is really a thing of the past. You don't find many new websites doing it, but when you're learning HTML, when you're learning how to create websites, it's a good practice to get into. So even though you don't see these as much as you once did, it's still a really good practice to check your code and to ideally not just make sure it's valid, but actually to add an icon, a badge that shows that it's valid and that you've checked it. And then often to take that extra step where you link to is really nice as well, though it's definitely not required. So I'm going to save this image. I'm going to save it into a folder called images. And while I'm here, I'm going to save the CSS one too. And then I'm going to do both colors, because you never know when you're going to want one of the other colors. So now if I go back to this placeholder, and I go in here, I'm going to go to image. I'm going to do the HTML5 blue one. All right, so there's that. I'm going to get rid of this text. And so this basically tells everyone that my code is valid. I can go one step further by clicking on it, and I can actually add a link to that validator. So if you remember this URL right here, by linking to it, it basically allows anyone to check my code as I update it. So alright, so now let's preview this. So if you go down here, let's try that once more. Oh, so I'm gonna move things. So you always got to pay attention. Sometimes I get click happy and I just click through. I'm going to refresh. There it is. And when I click on it, let's see, it brings me back to that URL and it checks the page again. So to do that same thing with CSS, if I Google CSS validation, you'll see that it comes up right away. Now there's basically two ways that you can do this. I can copy the URL and it's going to check the CSS on that page and tells me no errors were found. And it actually gives you here the older icons or badges, but like I said, the smaller ones kind of give a newer feel. But the other thing that I wanted to point out is sometimes you're going to have a site that has more than one CSS file. And so in this case, actually, all the CSS is within it. But let's go to, so here's an example of the syllabus. So I'm going to actually, because this has an external CSS file, I'm going to go to it and I'm going to click on it. And that gives me the URL, because now I can go back to this service and I can test whatever specific CSS file I want to find out what errors. And it says no errors were found. And so in this case, I can copy this and put this into my page. So let's just do that just to show you. I'm going to go to split view here. I'm going to put it right next to this. All right, so I could do that, but one problem is you generally want to make sure your badges, your icons are the same size and type. So I'm going to undo that. We're going to go back here. And you'll notice that if you want to create a link, it basically gives you this here where I can use this. So I can copy that, and you'll notice it also is up here. So if you want to pull it here, you can just copy that. We're going to go back down here, and we're going to go to Insert Image. We're going to use one of those badges that we already got. So we're going to actually, in this case, do CSS, and we're going to do blue. All right. And so now if I click off and click back on the image, I'm going to paste that in. Another important step with both of these is you always want them to open in a new window. So you want to make sure that blank is selected under target. And then for either of them, or for both of them, you want to make sure that you have an alt tag for that image. And so just like that, I'm going to save this, I'm going to upload it, I'm going to save this, I'm going to upload it, and then I'm going to test it once more, because it's always important to test your code at the end. So I come back, I refresh it, come down, you can see they're both down here. Check that, it opens a new window like it should. I can see that it's checking the right file and that it's valid. And do the same thing with the CSS, and just like that, no errors found. So that's the basic way you go about validating your code and making sure that it's error-free. Thanks.